Two men remain in critical condition tonight after being found motionless at the bottom of an Auckland swimming pool at the weekend. The incidents prompted a strong safety message from dive instructors. The swimmer who rescued them saying it appeared they were trying to hold their breath underwater. Simon Merced reports.
Two men went under of their own accord, but then had to be hauled to the surface. The man who saved them has swum for New Zealand and says they looked in bad shape.
There was a lot of discoloration on their face. They were coughing up blood when the CPR was being performed.
He says it was doctors using the Newmarket pool who resuscitated the pair.
So they were lucky?
Yeah, very lucky.
Joel Crampton says he was swimming in the middle lane of the pool and looked across and noticed two men lying next to each other on the bottom near this ladder. He carried on, did another couple of lengths, and on the way back, he says they were still lying there.
It looks like they were, you know, down there holding their breath. I'm not sure exactly if that's the case, but that's what it looks like.
Mike Smith has spent 15 years teaching breath control to divers. He says having someone monitor you is critical.
It can go wrong very quickly unless there's someone watching. So, yeah, like you can hold your breath for a long period of time and then you'll black out and then that's it. If your kids are saying, oh, I can hold my breath for a long time, discourage it. Do not even do that.
Joel Crampton says he's learned a lesson of his own.
If something looks dangerous in a pool or in the water, act on it. You know, I wish I probably went down there a bit earlier, but I can't change it now.
He says it didn't look like either of the men in trouble were supervising the other. Simon Mercep, One News.
Now, a short time ago, the family of one of the men issued a statement saying their son wasn't deliberately holding his breath underwater, but was swimming to touch the bottom of the pool.